And what Stephen said was, well, you know, we have computers now. You know, we should be able to do more of that. So instead of doing stop motion in a box, which is basically what we've been doing with 3D animation, how about we build individual characters and, you know, build AI into brains and give them their own vision and their hearing and let them go out on the battlefield and build them up with various, you know, predetermined behaviors and let them battle it out against each other based on what they find in their environment. They act or react on their own behalf. So as you can see, this was quite a revolution in filmmaking, a revolution in you know, the way we do animation. And it was something that nobody had really seen before. So what is Massive? I mean, Massive fundamentally is an AI authoring tool for non-programmers that allows us to create simulations that imitate life. And the way we do that is by building individual agents. I'm just gonna run through a couple of principles of Massive just because I know there are a lot of geeky nerds out there and you like it, okay? So, remember Agent Smith from The Matrix, you know, an agent is an AI entity, and agents Massive use natural senses, just like us, to navigate around their environment. They have vision, hearing, touch, and memory, and I don't know if you can see that guy, but all my videos are rather dark. We create a brain for the agent. This is an example of a brain. And as you can see, it's a node-based program. You don't have to, you know, it used to be you'd always have to, you know, sort of have a bank of programmers to create AI. And with Massive, it put that into the hands of the artists and allowed animators to actually create agents. Agents can see. This is a funny one because it was like an homage to ILM because in their, I think one of the Star Wars films later on, they were shooting each other in the back because they weren't very AI, you know, they weren't very smart, and so this is our way of saying, see, Massive agents wouldn't shoot each other in the back because they'd be identified as, you know, compadre. So this is my favorite shot in all of visual effects of all time. I don't know if they're going to show a final of it. I don't know if you guys remember this. But this is an example of a pre-rendered, you know, a temp render for one of the shots, and shows you how these, you know, agents come in different flavors, and you mix them up, and it looks very realistic. Agents can take any form. This is very unique. We have what we call an arbitrary skeleton, and you can make cockroaches, you can make fish, you can make, you know, birds, planes, trains, and automobiles. Do anything that moves on Earth, basically, can be animated with Massive. And now we've added memory, so agents can remember things. Well, why did we add that? You know, if you got a 5-10 second shot, if you don't like something that's going on, the director says, I don't like that thing that's going on in the corner, okay, just delete those guys, and then re-render it, and it goes in the film. And that's the, you know, definition of success. But what if you want to use Massive, this, you know, dominant player in film and TV, for real world scenarios, real world simulation? That's where the real meat of it is, and is actually related to what you guys are doing, which has to do with helping save the planet. You know, let's plan our cities better. Let's do urban planning, let's do transportation planning. When something like the Katrina mass tsunami happens, we would be prepared if we did